Good afternoon, everybody. Once again, welcome to 1 week online faculty development program on effective use of ICT tools for teaching and learning. Now, in the first part, we discussed word processing software, that is Microsoft Word. Now, we are going to discuss in second part, that is spreadsheet. So, in the second part, I will discuss about introduction to spreadsheet, features of spreadsheet, and the most important spreadsheet application software, that is Microsoft Excel. In Microsoft Excel, we will discuss some basic and general overview about the some important tabs in Microsoft Excel, that is Home tab, Insert tab, Page layout, Formulas, Data, Review, and then View tab. So first of all, we will discuss what is a spreadsheet. Exactly, it is also an application software. Spreadsheet is a file that exists of cells in rows and columns and can help arrange, calculate and sort data. Now, as we, in the last lecture, we discussed about that Microsoft Office is a package software. That means the name, it shows that Office, that means it has a package, that means number of software which is useful for the office purpose. In the word processing software, we prepare letters, memos and some other documents, but in Office we also need to prepare list, to make some kind of calculations, to process some kind of data. At that time we use that spreadsheet software. Now let's see again the definition. Data in a spreadsheet can be numeric values as well as text, formulas, references and functions. So that is the definition of spreadsheet. Now let's see the important features of spreadsheet software. In mostly each and every spreadsheet software, we will see some auto sum, that means auto calculations. Then we can create charts and graphs. There are also auto fill option, that means some information can be filled automatically. We can create auto shapes. There are various wizards for creating some functions or formulas, and you will see in the spreadsheet we will see the columns and rows. So now let's see, we will start with Microsoft Excel. So I already started Microsoft Excel. Once you start the Microsoft Excel software, you will get this screen. Once again, I will not repeat those options and those things which we already discussed in Microsoft Word. Exactly, there are various features and there are various options which are similar in each software, of Microsoft Office package. So I will not discuss again that what is copy, paste, bold, italic, font. So we will only discuss the important feature about the Microsoft Excel. So once again, there is a tab, Home tab, Insert tab, Page layout tab, Formulas tab, Data tab, Review tab, View tab. And in that tab you have ribbon, and each ribbon is divided into some sections. Here clipboard, font, alignment, number, styles, cell, and then editing. So mostly the important sections we already discussed in Microsoft Word, so we will not discuss about that. So now let's see, this is our working area. There is a table, so that table is our working area. So now exactly spreadsheet is a combination of columns and rows. So this is called as a column and this is called as a row, and the intersection of columns and rows is called as cell. This is a cell, this is column, this is row, and the intersection of the column and row is called as a cell. So this box is called as a cell. And in a spreadsheet in Microsoft Excel, every cell has its name or its address. Here we can see that every column has given alphabets, that is A, B, C, D, and it will go continuously. One Z completed, then A, B, C, and that will be continue. So it is a very spread sheet. It is a very wide sheet. In the same way, you will rows are have given numbers, so numbers are very much, so the sheet is very vast. So columns, rows, and then cell, intersection of column and rows. Now apart from that, if I select a few cells, so that is called as a range. So I am selecting some few cells, it is called as range. Now you will see here sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3, sheet 4, sheet 5. That means sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3, sheet 4 and sheet 5. And we can add more and more sheet here. And these combination of sheets are called as workbook. Whenever we save the file, exactly the file saved as a workbook. And each workbook have number of sheets. So right now just here we have sheets. If you want to get more and more sheets, then you just click here, you will get more and more sheets. So these are the basic information about the home tab, and some other information we will discuss in the next tab. Now let's see the next tab, that is insert tab. So in the insert tab we will discuss some important features only. Now again the illustrations we discuss in the Microsoft Word, again the text, word art, symbol we discuss in the Microsoft. Now charts, we also see in that topic, in that part in the Microsoft Word, but that is one of the important feature in Excel is the to create the chart. Now I already created here a table, that means year and cells, number of cells in each year is given. Now we have to prepare a chart on that table. Now I will put my cursor on that table, then I will click on my required chart. Suppose here column, then I selected this 2D column. Okay, so automatically it will create a chart. Now it is created that every year the volume of cell is given. It is very simple. Once we click the chart, you will get a separate menu, that is design. Here we can change the type of chart, colors and all those things, and format is also, we can also change the layout of the chart by clicking here. And if you wish to change the pattern of the chart, then change chart type, we can go there and we can prepare some other type of chart. Suppose we have to prepare a pie chart, then we will select this one and then okay, automatically the type of chart will be changed. The same design and those things we can change. So insert menu, the important aspect about that Microsoft Excel, that is a charts. Now come to the next menu, that is page layout. So page layout, again the same thing, margins, orientation, size. So these we already discussed in the Microsoft, so we will not discuss here. Now formulas. Now formulas, we discussed, one of the important feature in the spreadsheet software, that is we can make some kind of calculations. So there are various formulas we can use and can make a number of calculations. Suppose right now just I have prepared one table. Now I also shown there is a option, that is auto fills. That means we can fill information automatically. Suppose I have to prepare an invoice. Now I have to put serial number of the products. Now I have given 1 and 2. Now let's see the example of auto fill. I will select 1 and 2. Then I will click on that cursor and then will drag. Then number will be auto filled. In the same way, if you wish to create months, then just type 2 months only and select both the cells and then drag to that bar. automatically the information will be filled. So there are various other aspects also. So those who are interested to learn more about that aspect, I have given some other lectures also, so you can learn on that topic. So right now just we have to prepare some basic calculations and some basic informations about that. So suppose say here, now quantity, I will put some quantity here, red here, now we have to prepare amount, that means quantity multiplied by rate. So I will give you some one of the basic formula about that. While we are going to put any kind of formula into a cell, first of all we have to press is equal to. Now after pressing is equal to, we have to click on the required cell. Now I want to calculate, I want to multiply the value of this cell into the value of this cell. Okay, now I have pressed is equal to. Now I will click the value of E8, this one, sorry, E8, so this one E8, then I will put a sign of multiplication, and then I will click on F8, this means is equal to the value of E8 will be multiplied by the value of F8. Okay, once I put the formula, then I will press enter. Now the amount will be automatically calculated. Now it is not necessary to put the formula each and every time. Now I need the same formula from here also. So what I will do, I will just click there, and there is this one separate plus mark, so I will click and drag that mark. So automatically the formula will be applied, the sales value and sales information will be updated. You can see here the formula bar, the information. Here we can see the figure, but here you can see the formulas, actual formula. Once we change any quantity, the formula will be automatically updated, the information result will be automatically updated. Now we need to make a total of all the above informations. So there are some ready-made formulas also, just like here auto sum, that means automatically the amount will be added. So I will click here, then sum, this has taken G8 G12, that means it has taken the range, the value of range, that means the value of G8 to G12. So sum, that means that cell, that formula will add all the numbers in that cell. So and after putting that, I will press enter, then automatically you will get the result. So that is the basic and the basic formula. Now apart from that, we also have a number of other formulas also. So I will put my cursor here, then I will auto sum, enter, then you will get the automatically result. Then average, if you want to take average, just click average, enter, you will get average number. Just go there and click on count numbers, you will get the count numbers. Then click there, then maximum number, then minimum number. And apart from that, these are the very simple formulas, but Microsoft Excel can do a lots of calculations, just like you can logical, financial, look of references, mathematical, and about and more engineering, statistical, cube, information. So these are very advanced. So those who are to learn more and more about Microsoft Excel, also I am also giving some other lectures also. Otherwise, you can also search in the YouTube. Now let's see the next tab, that is data tab. Now in the data tab, we will discuss about sort and filter. I have given some numbers and some figures, some subjects, name of the subjects are here. Suppose these numbers are again, there is an option of to make the numbers ascending and descending. Suppose if I have to order these number into ascending order, first of all, I will select all the numbers and then I will click on the A to Z. That means sort is smallest to largest. Then it will automatically sort. The same if I want to get the reverse numbers, then sort largest to small. This much. In the same way, you can also change alphabetically A to Z or Z to A. Very simple. Now there is one of the important feature of Microsoft Excel is filter. I created a small table here, name of the students and then grade. These are the name and then these are the grade. Suppose if you want to get a separate list, the list of students who got B grade. At that time you have to sort out some data, so that at that time that feature is very helpful. Now I will click on that column and click on filter. Now it will assign two separate buttons here. Now I will click here grade. Now if I need information about the students who got only B grade only, then I will click here and then okay. So you will get the result of those students only. In the same way, if you want to get A and B. So these are the some important basic features of the Microsoft Excel. Again, there are some other features which we already discussed in the Microsoft Word. So it is really, as compared to micro features of the Microsoft Excel, I have given 0.0, I think 1% only maximum, because the Microsoft Excel is a very, very powerful tool. So those who are interested to learn more and more, so I am going to share some other videos also. Otherwise, you can also search to the Google. So once again, thank you everybody for watching this. Thank you.